Hi, today is teardown and a little bit of restoration project at the same time. This box with an handle, which is really hard. So we have here a piece of aircraft equipment, a navigation receiver, model number RV671. Made by EAS or Electronic Aerospatiale in Le Bourget, the famous business airport in the north of Paris. Date cov of 1971, serial number 206. So the issue with this thing is some damaged metal inside, bent metal. So I will try to repair it a little bit. In fact, it is very hard to slide out of the case. So what do we have? It is a mostly empty box, just some kind of radio receiver. So here you can see the damage. I do not know how it did happen, but I will try to hammer it a little bit. So we have a back connector like so with the number of contacts and coax for antenna, obviously. We have one big PCB on the back here. Looks like the tracks are gold coated and then conformal coated. We have a plug here which I think you can take it apart by undoing the little screws here, and it will separate in two parts, you will see. Here we have a completely shielded module, which will be interesting to look inside. And on this side, more shielded modules, a nice quartz filter, coax here, probably going to the antenna, and here, most probably, power supply section. So first I will disassemble the contents because if I want to repair this damage, I need to be able to hammer from the inside. So let me grab a screwdriver. So there is something interesting here. I'm not sure if you can see it, but this screw has a defect. In fact, I will undo this one first. The slot in the screw is not made all the way down. For some reason, I do not know how it did pass the quality control, but it is quite a fail, this one. I will probably replace it with another one when reassembling. So I believe the PCBs are mounted onto some kind of board-to-board interconnects. So I may be able to lift them. Let's start with this one, obviously. Yes, just little pins poking out from the copper side, and plugged in this receptacles here. So here is the first band, very old school track, as you can see. UN3773 transistor, two potted transformers, fuse, which seems to be in very sad condition, and a few more parts. Here we have more transistors, and maybe an op amp or volt, LM300, this one. In a socket, and the transistors are in socket also. So in fact I should be able to pull it like so, and I will even test it in order to make sure it is working. You can see very nice quality, the bottom of the case is gold plated. And yes, it is working perfectly. Okay, So let me reinsert this before I lose it. So this is the first board. Next board to come off. I need to find a spot for putting them in storage in the meantime. So next board will be this one. It looks like this connector is loose already, more or less. Yes, it is not easy to turn, but there's some kind of tiny coax connector. So I can undo this band. Exactly the same stuff, we have screws. Okay, it should be four of them. So we have an extraction handle here at the front, but it is very hard to undo. Okay, it goes like so. So I will remove this PCB. Hopefully it should come. There is no one screw in the middle, no? Okay, like this. So we will have a look inside these modules. But first I will try to do the repair on this. Okay. Very nice. Okay, so now from the left side I have one more big module. In fact, I am checking if yes, let's undo it completely. It is just a matter of undoing screws. So it will be maybe a little bit tedious to reassemble, but okay, next module. Oh, this one has a very nice pattern on the back. Some thing here poking out, not sure what it is. And this piece was loose, by the way. Okay, all the screws seems to be the same model for attaching these bands, so it is good. And I believe I must have some similar screws. So now I need to get rid of this connector. It will not be easy. So I will try to undo the metal clamp at the back. Like this. It is a holder piece for the inside, I guess, of the connector, the internal part. We have two very tiny screws here. And yes, it is now loose, it seems. So, if I undo on this side the four screws, I should be able to undo the complete connector body. But as you can see, the bolts are turning at the same time. So first I will undo the screws all around the PCB. They are very easy to undo, by the way. Enough. These are secured aircraft grade fasteners, but not here. There is just one washer, supposedly locking washer, but in fact we know they do not work well. And everything is loose, but I did never take it apart so far. So And we have another defective screw. Look at this one. This one, the slot is actually too deep. A hell of a lot too deep, and it is almost cutting the... It did reach the freed part. Quite interesting. They all unmade or something like this. Not sure what is going on here, but quite super surprising in fact. Okay, now this board is almost coming off. And I will need to undo also this fastener here. Okay, so let me grab the correct tool for it. So you need a 5mm wrench in this case, and you need a small enough screwdriver. So there are lock nuts, these ones seem to be made from aluminium, and there is a little nylon ring inside to prevent them from coming loose. With a correct tool, it is not an issue at all taking this apart. If you deal with any precision equipment, aircraft equipment or anything, you really want to have small wrenches under 5.5 mm. Okay, this is coming off quite nice. And now this piece is coming off also, but because of the shape here, I cannot pull off the PCB. So I will try to need to access it from the other side and remove the screw for the front plate here. Just one of them. Is stuck in my wrench. Okay, and now I must be able to undo this. Okay, nice. So I will try to deal with a vise and a hammer to repair this, and I will be right back. Okay, I think it is the best I can do with the tools I have. It is a little bit better for the shape. Sadly, there is some hammer marks now, but by the way, this piece is very flimsy, not terribly impressed by this. It is the middle PCB which makes all the rigidity of the assembly. And this piece part here is very, very easy to bend. And I think the damage was made by trying to push the assembly out of a case in which it was probably more or less stuck for some reason. Okay, so now we will have a look under the shadings on the PCBs. We will start with a big one. And by the magic of video editing, the screws are all gone suddenly. So what do we have? We have a very heavy cover, probably made of tin or silver plated copper with a lot of fingerprints inside, and they are not mine. And here is the contents. As you can see, a whole army of quartz. Frequencies 17.025 to 17.925. On this side, for instance, 87.525 here, 88, 86, 85. So maybe it is a transmit and a receive channel. and a lot of passive parts, resistors and capacitors and diodes. Here some coils, ajustable coils, which match this part at the back. And these screws here are for attaching the shielding frame in here. Interesting. Seems it is all handmade. The parts were unfitted on the board, by the looks of it. Very, very nice. The model number here on the edge with a nice logo of the manufacturer. Okay, so I will put this back together and we'll go to the other module. This module. Okay, we have the quartz filter is a welded box, so not really possible to open it. But here we have one shielding with it seems a number of screws over it. I am lazy, so maybe I will not undo the last one completely. Okay, like this. So what do we have in here? We have... Well, whoa, okay, let's do it. Span response, okay. So we have a bunch of compartments with debug mounted transistors, coils and capacitors, or some kind of active filter maybe. There are four legs transistors, by the way. Okay, here two tiny screws. Which will not. Oh, guess what? We have bolts on the back, nuts even. Because if not, it should be too easy to deal with it. So this thing was probably expensive, but there are some odd points in the construction, I think. Not really impressed. In particular with defective screws. It is totally not what you can expect in aircraft grade equipment. So I think it was for civil aircraft, airliner or something like this. Not military grade, but still. Okay. And guess what? It will perfectly not come off for some reason. I have no idea of what is happening here. It is really weird, this thing. So is it the same screw at this side? Or do we have some kind of a standoff internally? I do not know. It is probably the case of what is happening here. Sorry for this unexpected delay. But I think we have some kind of shit design here. Really. Quite annoying. Okay, I can see there is. In fact, oh yes, there is another. Do you see it? there is a PCB here, and there is another bolt between the two PCBs. So it means you cannot remove this cover if you do not unsolder the PCB. Really, really not impressed. So we will not see what we have inside this. I will try to push back these screws in place, and it will remain as is, I believe, because I do not feel I will bother trying to solder the thing with all the conformal coating over it. So this one is a fail. I will put it back together later. For now, at least we will have a, try to have a look inside this one. The screws are completely stuck, by the way, because this, I am sure, I did never access. So okay, and most important part here, nothing special to see. More some kind of active filters. Two transistors, 2N, 2-3, 8-3. And more caps and coils and resistors, as always. Okay. So I will reinstall this. And now I think it is time to start to reassemble the thing. It will be very fun probably with all these screws. Well, this one is going in a bad way because Murphy's Law. Very, very fun. Yeah, we are. Okay. So before I start to assemble the thing, I will check my box of random aircraft hardware to see if I can get replacement screws for the two defective ones. As you can see, I have quite a lot of stuff in here. Just rails, random fittings. These here are Soviet instrument mounting screws, some kind of wire fuse, O-rings, captive nuts, more fittings, and stuff. So I think they are metric screws, so it looks like they are all mixed together. Very nice. So I have this, which is probably the same thread than this. No, it is a little bit bigger. It is always an issue when you need to find screws in a whole pile of random junk and you want one particular kind of screw. And of course, if you need four, you will find three. What is this? No, it is bigger also. I guess it would be very fun, guys. What do we have in here? This is too big also. Oops. This is too small. If I had the time to sort all the screws by size, but I think this one at least, no, it is a little bit too small also. Oh, did the other box, this is supposedly only interiorly here. This seems mostly imperial too. But in here I do not see any screw the same with the same head design anyway, so I would like to find a perfect matching replacement, but I guess, what is this? No, too big. This one maybe. Too big also. Okay, so it looks like it is a fail and the defective screws will go back in place. No matter how many screws you have in stock, you never have the ones you need. It is pretty insane. So of course I have other screws elsewhere, but these are all taken apart from craft equipment, so or military equipment, so I was expecting to find the perfect match in this, but no. So I think this is, it is not 3, it must be 2 millimeters. So I will check another box, and if not, they will go back in place like so. So let me grab the other box. Must be or might be this one. So here are regular screws. This is also all from stuff I did take apart, by the way. And maybe I will be more lucky to find some kind of more or less similar screws. This. Which is perfectly too big. Oh, this is the correct size, but it is too long. This, yes, at least one. And it is fun because from the start, the screw I was getting as model is not the one I want to replace. Okay, let's do it again. It is this size. So it looks like we have one quite good match here. Not too bad. Maybe the head is a little bit too big, but we have another one here. Okay, so in fact, from the beginning, I was wrong, and I have screws like so. This is too long and seems to be imperial. Too small, so I think these two ones will go in place, in the replacement of a defective screw. I needed two of them. I have two, so I will not lose more time here. Another one. Okay, so what do we have in this box, by the way? If you're interested, this is a metricated metal-free screws, mechanical machine screws. We have Allen, we have a whole bunch of Phillips from printers and stuff. Slotted ones here, countersunk screws here, longer screws here, standoffs, and here bolts. And weird shaped screws in here. And it is one box out of many boxes. Okay. Aye. And the box did just bite me. Yes, it is hungry like this. So now it is time to start to try to reassemble the thing. So let's do it. Okay, guys, it is back together, and you know what? I think I need a beer. Really, this thing was insanely difficult to put back together. Nothing went as expected. Misaligned the holes for the screws, screws not fitting the thread, and all this. But now, at least, it is back together, and it will be perfectly useless for a few more years. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye.